What is up, you guys? Brooke here. So, you guys, I have made my 2021 writing plan, and my plan comes with deadline dates, the dreaded deadlines. I'm someone who doesn't really make deadlines, because normally whenever I do make deadlines, I don't finish what I'm trying to accomplish by that said deadline. But I am one day wanting to be an indie author, and this is my year. I'm transitioning from writer to author. I am needing to have a plan, to have deadlines and dates accordingly, which I have prepared and I am going to go over with you all on my handy dandy piece of paper. Since I have to shoot with my phone and not a camera, I can't read. See, this is my phone and it just beeped because I got a text. Since I can't read what I had typed up for you guys, I have to read it off of paper. And I also don't want to read it off of like my laptop. If I remove the laptop, the screen is black and everything is boring behind me. So in order to keep the prettiness that is Tiana in New Orleans, I am reading stuff off of paper. Old school paper, going back to old times, you guys. But that is what I'm doing today. I'm going over with you all my deadline dates for my book for all of this year. I'm not going to be publishing anything this year, so that's not going to be on my paper here. But I plan to write and finish the entirety of my book from first draft to very, 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 very last draft. So with all that being said, let's go ahead and go over my indie author timeline for 2021. So this is being shot in January of 2021. And later on, if I do not like stay with this timeline of things, I'm gonna be mega embarrassed, but I'm gonna be mega proud that I at least tried to stay on track with these dates I have here, or not so much dates, with the months I have written down here. For January, I plan to start and finish my first draft. So let me preface this whole thing with saying that I do this a lot. And am I showing you the right thing? I do this a lot in my whole deadline thing where I say and finish or and start in parentheses. I do that because I'm giving myself a little bit of breathing room. I'm having it to where it's like, hey, I could finish this on this month, or I'm gonna let that task bleed into the next month. Because if I just needed a little bit more time, I don't wanna put so much pressure on myself to have it exactly finished on that month, or to have things exactly start on that month that I have listed here. So anyway, with that being said, let me start over with January now. So January, I plan to start and finish draft one. Right now it is the middle of JanoRimo, which not many people know of. JanoRimo is pretty much doing NaNoWriMo in January, except you can play with whatever goal you're wanting to accomplish with your book. And my goal for JanoRimo has been to start and finish my first draft of my book. By this time right now that I'm shooting this video, is that going according to plan? Am I getting close to finishing my first draft? Not really. Things are happening. Things are in the works. So for some reason, if I do not finish that first draft during the month of January or JanoRimo, that's okay, because this right here, the and finish draft one, is there for me. So that way it can bleed into February, which we are going into right now. In February, the goal is to possibly finish draft one, but to overall reread my story and to start and possibly finish draft two. So I'm giving myself lots of leg room here, but I'm still setting these goals for myself, because I am saying, hey, if I didn't finish draft one in January, now be the time. So for sure, my draft will be done by February. Gosh dang it, it will get done. And then once I am finished with that draft, I am going to reread the story in its entirety, and I'm going to make those adjustments to the story. And whenever I say make adjustments to the story, and also when I say start and finish draft two, with all of the draft two stuff, it's to where I'm making adjustments to the story. And when I say story, I am meaning story. I am not doing heavy edits. I am not doing really much of editing, like line editing, I guess you should say. I'm not gonna be like correcting grammar. I'm not gonna be fixing my sentences to look prettier. I am focusing on story elements here, folks. I'm fully just working on making the story correct, making the plot make sense. So I'll be starting draft two and I might finish draft two. It's a possibility of finishing draft two. Also, it's the shortest month of the year. If I don't finish draft two, that's okay, because that bleeds into March. See right there, finish draft two. I have that bleeding into March as well. Draft three is gonna be kinda like the first stage of prettifying my book. I am making it to where I am adding more to my descriptions, or I'm adding more to dialogue, or adding more setting, descriptions, but I'm just adding a lot more to draft three, making it to where it's a lot more of visualizing the world I'm in, or visualizing what my character is experiencing. So I'll be starting draft three in March, and then in April time, I will be still going into draft three, still doing all of those things I had just said, but I will have it to where I will wrap up draft three in April time. And now here's a word from today's sponsor, Skillshare. Skillshare is an online community filled with thousands of classes fit for any type of creative or curious person out there. Skillshare is fully focused on learning and the whole process of learning something new and not being interrupted with ads. There are no ads during each lesson that you go through. And the lessons are taught by professionals in whatever industry that they are in. And as you know me, with my writing channel here, I'm interested in taking lots of their writing courses that they have to offer in Skillshare. The writing class that I just took was by Simon Bambui. He was the instructor, and he was so calming to listen to. He's British, which made it even more just relaxing. Simon's class was the Writer's Toolkit, which focused on 6 steps to a successful writing habit. I like how Simon said how people aren't necessarily born with a talent for writing, that they are more so born for the obsession for writing. It wasn't that they were born with that talent, it was that they were born with the obsession for that talent. I loved that. And something he said to do and to try out to kind of play with your writing style, to find your writing style, was to find a book that you really, really enjoy, but to find a paragraph in that book that you felt like probably could have been tweaked with a little bit here and there. And so he says to do that, to find your own writing style, go ahead and write down a paragraph of words that you felt like could have had some tweaking, tweak it yourself and make it your own. And that is a great way of playing with your own writing style. So since I just learned tips on how to keep with a successful writing habit that are going to be great for 2021, I can now dive into another class. And one that I'm really looking forward to is by Daniel Jose Older. And his class is Storytelling 101, which is covering character, conflict, context, and craft. The 4 C's. Really excited for Daniel's class because he's gonna go over the fundamentals of narrative storytelling. So anyone who's a writer would love that. Skillshare is a monthly subscription that is lower than $10 a month, but if you wanted to, there is a link below in my description box to where if you wanted to give Skillshare a try for free, the first 1,000 people that clicks the link below, you will be able to try out Skillshare for free on the free trial that they are providing for you. Just make sure to remember to click on that link below so that way you can get your free trial of Skillshare today. By May time, it is time to do editing. And this is more so editing than what I had been doing before. I mean, obviously, I'm gonna be editing the drafts whenever I'm beefing up the drafts or when I'm tweaking with the story elements and whatnot. I'm gonna be editing throughout this time, but this is like more so the heavy edits. This is making sure that things are the way they need to look. Grammar-wise, sentence structure-wise, I wanna make sure that my sentences don't sound clunky or odd or just unnatural. This is gonna be the time of where I am making things the way I am wanting them to look here on out for the most part. So May will be the time of whenever I start editing. I will start the editing in May that goes into June. June is also gonna be my editing month, and that should be wrapping up in that month as well. And once I am done editing in June, it is time to reread my story because I need to make sure that my book is as close to being a complete finished book as it can be. And then I'm gonna be rereading the book actually in June after I'm done editing. And that's to make sure before it is time to send it out to betas that it's as complete of a book as it should be, and just making sure I don't need to tweak anything else or just make a final little edit of if I had missed a certain edit beforehand. And since I did just mention betas in the month of June, June is also going to be the month that I start looking for betas. It will most likely be on YouTube only, YouTube and also my Patreon. Patreon people, if anyone who is a patron of mine, you will be first in line to becoming a beta reader for me if you want to, that is. You do not have to if you don't want to, but if you want to, awesome, then you can be a beta reader for sure. You are first in line for that. But all that is happening in June. I am finishing the editing, I'm doing a final read through, and I'm also looking for betas. Which then brings us to July. If for some reason I didn't finish reading my book for the final time in June, then that will bleed into July, where I will finally finish the final read through of my book before it's sent out to betas. And then with that being said, July is the time of whenever I do send my book out to betas. So my book will be out of my hands and will be with you lovely people if you want to read it, that is. So once my book is out there for people to read, then that is whenever I will start my second book out. Am I pointing to it correctly? Second book outline. I will not be done outlining this book probably at this time, or if I do, awesome, but I don't know if I will finish it this month or not. By August, hopefully all of my betas will be done with reading my book. So that is whenever I will get their beta feedback and I will read through their feedback and I will apply their feedback to the book overall, while also continuing to outline my second book in the series. So now comes September on the list here. September, I am wrapping up my book, baby, at that time. By September, I am pretty much almost done, hopefully. I will be reading through the book probably for the last time. I even have right here, for the last time. And while I am reading it through that hopefully final time, I can keep in mind the outline for my second book. I can kind of make revisions if there were things from the outline for book two, if there were things I should have been putting in book one, I can be putting that in now. Okay, so flipping the page, you guys, and this brings us to October here. October is gonna be my catch-up month, or it's gonna be my month of just researching, publishing stuff, or just enjoying life. I love October time. I might just enjoy life during the month of October. And then for November, that's whenever I will work on book two. That is hopefully gonna be also finished in that month as well. And then by December time, look at that. I'm gonna take a massive break. December time is gonna just be me taking a break and also rereading book two's first draft. Or if I needed to, finishing up book two's draft, if I wasn't able to finish it during NaNoWriMo time. You guys, that's it. That is my 2021 timeline of the whole year. I feel like I have a game plan. And so now, talking about my deadlines for 2021, this feels more real now for my book to have its start and completion all in this new year here. So, okay, I'm excited. I'm excited for all of 2021. I'm excited to see where my book journey goes this year. Hopefully, things go according to plan. So let me know down below, you all, if you have a game plan or strategy or deadlines in mind for 2021. And if you're excited about it or if you're not so excited about it. Like, how are you trying to keep yourself on track of getting your books done? And remember to go check out the description below so you can click the link for Skillshare so you can get a free trial for all of their creative lessons today. And if you liked this video, feel free to give me a big thumbs up down below. I'd really appreciate it. And also, don't forget to subscribe because I post writing-related content every week here. And thank you all so much for stopping by today, and may the words be with you. Bye!